स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुंह देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखनित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिर्धृत्यत्व निर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव अन्नमत्वनिति मे निश्चितामतिः। Still there is background noise. Okay. Anyway. So we are looking at the Shunyavada refutation. We'll come back to this because he's a little ahead of the Moola. Anyway, let's finish it. It's okay. Sometimes, you know, something that is going to come up in the Moola, a part of it is mentioned in the earlier Tippana. So sarvam shunyam, shunyam eva paramatattvam. This is the nihilism or Buddhist nihilism or shunyavada. Shushupti kalina ajnana rupa anandame kosheva atma. Iti idam madhyamikam, madhyamikam matam api asangatam eva. This is a madhyamika mata. Shunyavadis say this way, but they do not say that anandame kosha eva atma. This is what we understand from their analysis, as we saw earlier also. If you analyze what their mata is and look at the Siddhanta, then in Siddhanta, all that they have concluded appears to be the Anandamaya Kosha, but not the Atma really. Tathahi kim shunyam sakshi sahitam uta sakshi rahitam uta swaprakasham iti tridha tatra vikalpo bhavati. So to this shunyavadi, question is asked as to what is this shunya that you talk about. Is it with sakshi, meaning do you know that shunya exists? Are you a witness to it? So shunyam kim sakshi sahitam uta sakshi rahitam, with or without sakshi, what is this shunya? Then if it is neither sakshi sahita not sakshi rahita, it is itself, by itself, swaprakasham. Meaning, it is not an object to sakshi who is present. It is not an object to a non-sakshi. It is by itself self-shining, that kind of shunya. So it does not need another sakshi. What exactly are you trying to say by shunya? Then these are analyzed. Adya pakshe, meaning if it is sakshi sahita shunya. Yaha shunyasya sakshi sa shunyad vilakshana atma siddhyati. If you say nothing exists other than the sakshi, then this sakshi is the atma, not shunya. Therefore, your conclusion of shunya being atma is wrong. Dvitiya pakshe, if you say it is sakshi rahitam, no, it is a shunya where there is no sakshi, then dvitiya pakshe sakshi rahitatva shunyam evana siddhyati. Then how do you know that the shunya exists, that there is shunya? How do you know that there is shunya if there is no sakshi to it? Who will make that conclusion? So either you have to say that shunya exists whereby sakshi exists, or you have to say that shunya isn't there, because sakshi not being there, who is going to assert shunyatvam? So you have a flaw in either paksha, either of the earlier two pakshas. Now this is similar to, if you cannot see what it is really being said, if you look into a room which is an empty room, just constructed building. You go to buy an apartment or something and you look at a room which is empty. Then if you see if there is something or someone there, you say, no, nothing is there. So you who have entered the room and saying that there is nothing, you are missing yourself. Just like the light that we miss the person who is making the statement, because that person is in the room. So if someone is there in the room, no one is there. When we say no one is there, shunya, that time no one other than me is there is understood. Even if the listener or the questioner who asks as to who is there in the room and the person in the room answers that there is no one, then it is understood obviously that the person who is saying that there is no one, that person exists. He is in the room. So that is a sakshi sahitam. If you say sakshi rahitam, if no one answers, you know, if someone knocks on your door, ask who's there inside, is there anyone home, and no one answers, so you cannot say that shunyam is there, because you are the witness. If you say nobody is there in the room because you didn't hear the answer, you cannot assume that you are also not there. So it's a sakshi rahitam. You know that there is nothing in the room. Let's say, or a better way to see this, because this will be similar to the earlier paksha. If you knock on the door and ask who is there, what is there, if no one answers, you may conclude that person, no person is there. But can you conclude that nothing other than that is there? You cannot conclude as to whether someone is there or someone isn't there. Something is there or something isn't there. You cannot conclude that nobody is at home also, because a person may be sleeping and didn't hear you. You can conclude nothing. So you cannot assertively say, you cannot say definitely that there is no one or nothing inside the room. So sakshi rahitam, that paksha, dvitiya paksha sakshi rahitatvat, since sakshi isn't there, shunyam evana siddhyati. You have not seen what is there inside or not there inside, so you cannot make a conclusion as to the room being empty. Shunya. So it is a ubhaya pasha rajju in the earlier two pakshas. If you say shunya is there, then you have witnessed, and therefore there is nothing called as shunya, meaning nihilism is not established. Nothingness is not established because you are there as a sakshi. That is the atma. If you say no, there is no one, then who made the statement that shunya is there? Who can assert? Nobody can conclude that shunya is there. Then the last paksha, tritiya pakshe, saprakashatvad asmadabhimatam brahmeva shunyam iti namantarena uktam bhavati. And if you say no, I don't take to the earlier two pakshas, I mean to say that the shunya does not need a witness because it is swaprakasha. If shunya is swaprakasha, then it is existent. Even the shunya exists statement shows existence. There is an anuvritti of sat. You cannot say shunya exists. That itself is a contradictory sentence. You cannot say nothingness is. There is nothing. That there is nothing itself, that isness is pervading there. Nasato vidyate bhavaha, nabhav vidyate sataha. So sataha abhavana vidyate. Shunya, abhava rupa shunya, is not possible because sat anuvritti will be there. If ghata isn't there, you say ghata isn't there, then the ghata, broken ghata, isn't there as ghata, but then sat, which was manifest in the form of ghata, is there in the form of the broken pieces now. So sat hasn't gone. Satta is still there, pervading the pieces of the pot. This is what Bhagavan Bhashyakara explained under the Gita verse. Nasato vidyate bhavaha ityadi. If at all you say that it is there, shunya is there, then shunyatvam known to itself by itself makes it chetana, makes its existence. Satta is also there, spurti is also there now. Svaprakashatvad. First satta by saying shunyam asti. Then svaprakashatvad, if you say the tritiya paksha, which is svaprakasham iti. Svaprakashat. Svaprakasham shunyam. If you say that, then tritiya pakshe svaprakashatvad asmad abhimatam brahma eva. We also say sad brahma, chid brahma. Then you are talking about the same brahma that we talk about, but you have given it a different name. Shunyam iti namantarena uktam bhavati. You can take any paksha. The earlier two pakshas are contradictory to your conclusion. I mean, earlier to conclusion are contradictory to logic. Either you have Sakshi, in which case Shunya isn't the Atma, Sakshi is the Atma, because it is existent. Shunya is non-existent. If you take the second paksha, then no conclusion can be drawn. So you know, have no philosophy at all, really. So there is no discussion possible. In fact, earlier paksha, Sakshi is there, something can be discussed. Sakshi Rahitatvat, there is no one to witness Shunya, no one to claim that Shunya is the reality. And there is no discussion is possible, because you yourself, in fact, it means that you who are claiming yourself to be the philosopher, you yourself do not exist. Asanneyo bhavati. Taittiriya Upanishad, asanneyo bhavati. One who says, brahmanasti, he does not even know that he is Brahma. Brahma is nothing but another name for Atma, which is nothing but the reflexive eye. This person has missed that and says that nothing is there, meaning he himself has denied Brahma is not there, he is not there. Then who am I talking to? Therefore, it is illogical. In the third paksha, we say welcome to the Vedanta Tattva itself. You can call it by any name, because Brahma is just a name which is mithya. Brahma name is also mithya. So you can use shunyam. We don't have an issue as long as you say svaprakasha is the swarupa of shunya itself. Tathacha shunya asiddhi eva. So shunya as nothingness is illogical. That is not possible. Asadva idamagra asit, asad deva idamagra asit. Taittiriya Upanishad as well as Chandogya, both have these statements. Asat. Earlier there was asat. Asat, why is vai? Eva kararthe. So asat vai idam agre asit. Agra is agre. So asat vai, that asat that is talked about there, Agre Asit, does not mean that Asat is the reality. What is being said, it is not Asad Asit. Idam Jagat Agre, meaning Srishtehe Prak Purvam Asad Asit. Meaning that Asad Asit itself has absolutely no meaning. But if you take Jagat Asad Asit, Jagat wasn't there. Earlier the world wasn't there. Then it makes sense. Otherwise Asad Asit has no sense. Nama Rupatmakam Jagat Srishte Prak Asad Asit Nasit Ityartha. Nama Rupatmakam Nasit. What was it? It was Sad Rupa. Only Sat was there. Now Sat and Nama Rupa both are there. It was unmanifest. That is the idea in that mantra. So it is not Shunyavada. Shunyavada is refuted in the next mantra itself, in Chandogya. Asadeva idam agra asit. Same meaning there. Ityadi vakyani purva para virodhat. If you look at the mantra, asadva idam agra asit, and what comes up next? Satyam jnanam anantam brahma. they are contradictory. Purva para virodhat, seemingly contradictory. So your interpretation of asat, Brahma asat, Atma asat is wrong. If at all the Shunyavadi quotes the Vedas, they do that sometimes, and just to show that your Shruti itself says that, they'll handpick some mantra and try to say this is how your Shruti says. And in Asadeva Idamagrasit also, in Chandogya also, the following mantra, where the entire creation is talked about from Saddevata, there Asat is refuted. So Purva Paravirodhat Na Shunyam Pratipadayanti. These mantras, there are so many mantras which may mention Asat, but the Asat there is unmanifest form of the Prapancha. Prapancha not being there, it was in the form of Sat itself. Now it is in the form of Nama Rupa also after Srishti. Kintu Nayayika Vaisheshika Baudhadeha Pragabhavadin Jagataha Karanatvena Varnayanti. So Jagataha Pragabhava. Pragabhava is prior non-absence. So prior non-presence. So prior absence. So prior absence, prior to creation, the absence of that ghata ityadi that exists. In ghatabhava. Ghatabhava is what? Ghatasya pragabhava. Abhava is of four types in Nyaya we have seen earlier. So pragabhava is the abhava of ghata. Ghata pragabhava is the abhava of ghata before it was manifest or created. So it was not in the form of ghata nama and ghata rupa. It was there in the mrud itself. So you look at ghata as asat, because nama rupa isn't there. Similarly, if you extend it to prapancha, jagat, then jagat was what? Before Srishti, I'll say Srishti instead of saying creation or manifestation, Srishti, before Srishti, Prag Srishtehe, it was, there was Pragabhava of Jagat. So, Nayayika Vaisheshika Baudhadayaha Pragabhavadin Varnayanti. So, what they are talking about are just, they are talking about Pragabhava. Jagataha Pragabhava. Karanatvina. In Nayayika's Mata also, Nyaya Vaisheshika means Tarkika's also, they talk about Pragabhava as Karana. Ghata, Ghatasya Pragabhava, Ghata Pragabhava has to be there. And when you talk about Nayayika's and Vaisheshika's, you have to separate them from Bauddha's. Because Nayayika Vaisheshika talk about Pragabhava as one of the Karanas for that particular entity. So if you talk about ghata pragabhava is needed for ghata to be there. Otherwise, if ghata pragabhava is not there, then ghata is there. Because pratyogi is there. Yasya bhava sa pratyogi. So ghata abhava and ghata are contrary to each other. You cannot have both simultaneously. Pragabhava. Any abhava, but pragabhava. Ghata pragabhava, if you say, means ghata is created, is there. Then pragabhava cannot be there, because before the ghata, that ghata abhava is called as pragabhava. If ghata abhava is there, then ghata cannot be said to be there. If ghata is there, then you cannot say ghata abhava is there. So ghata pragabhava is there or ghata is there. When the ghata is created, that time pragabhava goes. Ghata pragabhava. Therefore, they conclude that ghata pragabhava is one of the samagris needed, karana needed for ghata as karya. However, Baudhadayaha, the Buddhists, they talk about abhava, taking cue from tarka. They borrow something from Vedas, they look at the Tarkika's analysis, and they are all Tarka Pradhana. Buddhists also, they are also looking at Tarka, and then they borrow this Pragabhava and conclude this Pragabhava means Shunya, because it isn't there, something is born out of nothing. That is not possible. However, Nayeka Vaisheshika, when they are talking about Pragabhava, they also talk about Mrit as Ghatakarana. Ghatak Pragabhava, but Mrit is there. Mrit has to be there. They can include Ishvara also as a Karana, Kala also as a Karana, Danda also as a Karana, Chakra also as a Karana, and Mrit also as a Karana. But Mrit is Asadharana Karana. Therefore, Mrit that exists is Karana. They are not talking about Pragabhava alone. Pragabhava is inferred because they have got some terminology they want to talk about how their system came about. Pragabhava cannot be talked about. Vedantins do not agree with categorization of Abhava. But if you look at what kind of Abhava, they say Pragabhava was there before Ghatotpatti. Then they are talking about Abhava which is existent. It is Yatkinchit Bhavarupa Abhava, which itself is contradictory, but you have to think something of that order, something of that sort. However, Buddhists do not mean by that kind of an Abhava. They have misunderstood Pragabhava also, and they think that it is Shunya. It is not nothing, it is not from nothing that the Ghata comes about or Prapancha comes about. In their understanding, the Mrit has to cease to exist to for Ghata to be formed. So in Shunyavada, Karana is Shunya itself because anything that existed has to get destroyed for something else to come about, and that destruction is Shunya Rupa. And from that destruction, which is of Shunya Rupa, which is in the form of Shunya, meaning nothing, something is born, therefore Shunya is the Karana. This is the Bauddha Mata, Shunyavadi Madhyamika. Whereas Nayayika Vaisheshikas do not talk about in this manner. They say Ghata Pragabhava is there. And where is Ghata Pragabhava? Ghata Pragabhava is there in Mrit itself. So Mrit is there. There is a huge difference between Nayayika Vaisheshikas also and Bauddhadaya, because Bauddhadaya, all these Ashastriya, they have no basis whatsoever. Nayayika Vaisheshika at least fall back on something selectively in the Vedas. But Shastra Rahitatvat, Bauddhadayaha, they don't have any basis to conclude. So they are completely off the charts. Tadanudya Tadrusha Viparita Graha Nivartane Eva Tadrusha Shrutinam Tatparyam. So what is the Tatparya of the Shruti when it mentions Asadva Idamagra Asit or Asadeva Idamagra Asit? Tatparya is to refute those matas. Shruti knows Anadi Kalina Srishti is there. Srishti is cyclical. So Anadi Kalina. So this Bauddha Mata, which has come up very recently, has come up in earlier Kalpa also, and earlier, yet earlier Kalpa also. It is cyclical. So these matas in various forms will be there across Kalpas. And Shruti, which is anadi, really anadi, because it is manifest the way it was earlier. Shabda Brahma Rupa Shruti knows that these matas will come up, and Khandana has been done a priori. So it has been refuted earlier itself that these ideas should not be entertained. Tadanudya Tadrusha Viparita Graha Nivartane Eva Tadrusha Shruti Nam Tatparyam. The Tatparya is to refute these matas. Asat, what does it mean now? Asat, Asadva Idamagrasi, there Asat, or Asad Eva Idamagrasi, there Asat is what? Anabhivyakta Nama Rupatmakam. What is Asat there? Unmanifest Prapancha, which is Nama Rupatmaka, is unmanifest. So Nama Rupa isn't there before Srishti. So what is really Srishti? Srishti is giving Nama and Rupa to Karana. That is what we call as Karya Prapancha. Idam is Jagat. Agre is Srishte Prak. Asid iti Shrutyartha. Itham Shunyavada Asangata Eva. So Shunyavada is baseless. Bauddha Shishya Chatvara. So there are four Shishyas who have created four kinds of philosophies in Buddhism itself. So we don't need to go into details. Madhyamika Shunyavadi, Yogachara is Kshanika Vijnanavadi, Sautrantika Anumeya Bahya Padarthavadi. So we get some idea about Anumeya. All Tarka Pradana, but they Bahya Padarthavadi, Sautrantika, they base themselves on Buddha's sutras, they say. Vaibhashika Pratyaksha Bahyarthavadi. So Bahyarthavada based on Pratyaksha, and here Bahyarthavada based on Anumana. That is the difference between Vaibhashika and Sautrantika. Yogachara and Madhyamika we saw as Kshanika Vijnanavada and Shunyavada in this Grantha itself. The Mula we have done here. So that is a Tippana. This will come up in the Mula also in bits and pieces. We'll rush through a little there when it is repetitive. Prabhakara Nayayika Matam. So Nayayika Mata, which is same as the Mata brought about by Prabhakara. So Prabhakara was the Shishya of Kumarala Bhatta, Purva Mimamsaka. He differs from his guru in details. And there is quite a difference. Philosophical differences are there. Anandamaya Kosha Atma. So they also conclude on Anandamaya Kosha as Atma, but there is a difference there. What is the difference there? Purva Mimamsaka Eka Deshina. So we saw Eka Deshi, I had mentioned earlier. Purva Mimamsaka Eka Deshina. Prabhakara. The followers of Prabhakara, Prabhakara, Nayayikaha Cha Evam Kathayanti. They talk about Atma in this manner, na Atma Shunya Rupa. They refute Shunya Vada. Their main goal, Prabhakara Mata, is a little different from Bhatta Mata. Because the main tatparya there, philosophically, is to refute the Shunya Vada. There was a lot of attack from Shunya Vada on Purva Mimamsa, on Vaidika Dharma. So Prabhakara, they took the entire effort towards refuting the Shunyavadis, Buddhists basically, so that the Vaidika Dharma is retained, it wins over and it continues to be there. So we owe them a lot. It is not that, you know, Purva Mimamsakas should be thrown off. Purva Mimamsakas are the ones because we have Uttara Mimamsa. Uttara Mimamsa is not possible without Karma Kanda. Vedanta is impossible without Karma Kanda following. That has to be there for Chitta Shuddhi. And that has been retained. They have created the entire Mimamsa Shastra. No such Shastra exists in the world where the textual analysis is so brilliant. And analysis of such a vast subject, even after losing so many Shakas, innumerable Shakas, we still have very little. And that itself is so vast. They have analyzed through and through and made it easy for every darshana to follow. So Purva Mimamsa is assumed to be one of the qualifications. Study is assumed to be one of the qualifications for a Vedanti. Otherwise, Uttara Mimamsa is not possible. Purva Mimamsa ka ika deshinaha prabhakara nayayikascha evam kathayanti na atma shunya rupaha. Atma shunya rupa iti vadan evam prashtavyaha. So they say, you ask the Shunyavadi, what should be asked? Shunya rupam tena anubhuyate navaiti. Tena shunyavadina shunya rupam anubhuyate nava iti. Do you have anubhava of shunya or not? Basically same thing that we saw in the tippana earlier. Are you a sakshi to the shunya or are you not? That is the anubhava, sakshi anubhava. Do you know shunya as asserted from yours anubhava or without anubhava? Yadi shunya rupam anubhuyate, tada yena tat shunya rupam anubhuyate, saivatma. If you say there is anubhava, then whoever had anubhava of shunya, that entity is atma. So shunya is not atma at all. Such a shunya vilakshana iti cha siddhyati. Because you, one who has anubhava, he is the subject, he is different from the object which is shunya. यदि शून्य रूपम नानुभूयते तदा शून्यमेव नास्ति इति सिद्ध्यति. इफ देयर इज नो अनुभव ऑफ शून्य देन हाउ विल यू हैजर्ड शून्यत्वम बीइंग देयर. यू कैन नॉट नो. देयरफॉर शून्य इज नॉट एस्टैब्लिश्ड एट ऑल. अनया रीत्या शून्य विलक्षणात्मा सिद्धः. आत्मा इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम शून्य. तस्य आत्मनः मनसा संयोगे ज्ञानम उत्पद्यते. नाउ दिस इज द पक्ष ऑफ नैयायिकास एंड प्राभाकर. व्हाट इज द मत? तस्य आत्मनः मनसा सह संयोगे ज्ञानम उत्पद्यते. दिस ज्ञान विच इज देयर विच द सिद्धांति वेदांति सेज दैट इट इज स्वप्रकाश आत्मा चिद्रूप आत्मा विच इज इट्स इनहेरेंट स्वरूप. ज्ञान इज इट्स ओन स्वरूप. वेर एज वॉट डू दी नैयायिकास से पूर्व मीमांसकास एंड नैयायिकास दे से दैट आत्मनः मनसा सह संयोगे ज्ञानम उत्पद्यते. दैट ज्ञान दैट यू टॉक अबाउट is not its swarupa. So they don't consider this chetanatva as swarupa. They say this jnana is there in the atmanah manasa sanyoga. Jnana utpadyate. Since there is a sanyoga between atma and manas, that time there is jnana utpatti. Tena jnana rupena gunena atma chetanah bhavati. So atma is not chetana. In their opinion, atma is jada. This is the conclusion. How do you come to that conclusion? Because jnana rupena gunena atma chetano bhavati. There is this jnana rupa guna. Jnana is a guna. That guna manifests in the atma when there is sanyoga with manas. Of course, there can be differences because nayayikas also, they have analyzed and there are some differences there also. But jnana is a guna. This is common across the nyaya differences also. Jnana is a guna in the atma. Therefore, chetanatva is only, it appears as though it is a quality. It is a property of atma. Swarupa, swarupatha tu atma jadaha. Atma is jada, but only with manas sanyoga, this guna manifests in atma, making it chetana. Sukha-dukha iccha dvesha prayatna dharma adharma api atmanah guna iti. And atma does not have only jnana as guna, but has sukha as guna, dukha as guna, iccha, dvesha, prayatna, dharma, adharma. These are all atma gunas. This is nayayika mata. And followed by Prabhakara's also. Tanmate api आनंदमय कोशेव आत्मा. सो व्हाट दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इज आनंदमय कोश. हाउ सो? वेदर दे एग्री और नॉट इन अवर कंक्लूजन इफ यू लुक एट व्हाट श्रुति इज प्रेजेंटिंग एंड व्हाट दे हैव एनालाइज्ड यू सी दैट दे हैव नॉट लैंडेड ऑन आत्मा एट ऑल. दे हैव ऑल्सो कंक्लूडेड विथ आनंदमय कोश. हाउ सो? विज्ञानमय कोशस्थाह या बुद्धि ही सा आत्मनः ज्ञान रूप गुण इत्युच्यते. व्हाट इज दिस गुण? So if you ask them, pray tell, what is this guna, jnana guna, where is it? You say it is in the atma, guna manifests in the atma, where is it? That guna, ya buddhi, sa atmanah jnana rupa guna ityuchyate. It is atma guna. If you say atma guna, you have analyzed that atma guna by association with the manas, antakkarana. That antakkarana, which takes the role of buddhi, which we call as vijnanamaya kosha. That time that vijnanamaya kosha sthaya buddhi, that buddhi sa atmanah jnana rupa guna iti uchyate. That buddhi is called as guna because it is jnana rupa. It becomes guna of atma. This is how you have concluded. Tatha hi anandamaya koshe chaitanyam guna maste. In Anandamaya Kosha, Chaitanya is there. It is hidden. Viveka hina nam na tat pratiyate. Unless you analyze, you won't see that it is there. In Anandamaya Kosha, it is there. It is not that Vijnanamaya Kosha you have to borrow Chaitanya from. In Anandamaya Kosha also, it is there. You are thinking that it is in Vijnanamaya Kosha and then with association it is born in the Atma, but actually it is manifest in Anandamaya Kosha also. So Vivekahinanam na tat chaitanyam pratiyate tasmat prabhakaraha nayayikascha shushuptam atmanam jnanahinam manvanaha swarupatah eva atmanam jadamahuhu. They analyze the Atma in Shushupti as Jada because there is no Jnana there. Only when one wakes up, that time there is Manas Sanyoga, and due to that Manas Sanyoga, the Vijnanamaya Kosha association makes that, which is Buddhi association, makes a person as though come alive. That is misunderstood as Chetanatvam being manifest in Atma, which wasn't there earlier. So they have missed out to analyze that in Sushupti also Chetanatvam is there. Sukamaham Aswapsam Nakinche Avedisham, that is the conclusion of the waker, recollection. Through recollection. Therefore, recollection being possible only through collection. There was this Chetanatva Sukha, Sukatva, and not knowing anything. Being collected during Sushupti Avastha. So who will collect it? Chetana is there, witnessing this darkness and Sukha. So they have concluded as Atma being Jada because they think that Sushupta Atma is Jnanahina. Therefore, Chaitanya isn't there. Therefore, Manas Sanyoga is needed for Atma to get that Guna. Tasmad Guda Chaitanya Anandame Koshi Eva Tayoho Atmatva Bhranti Rasti. So where is the Atmatva Bhranti? That Jada Anandamaya Kosha is considered as Atma, which gets the Buddhi Guna on waking up with Manas Sanyoga, and that Buddhi is being the Guna of Atma. Now Atma becomes Chetana, which is Anandamaya Kosha becoming Chetana really. Atma not becoming Chetana because Anandamaya Kosha was thought about as Atma, which is Jada, or Anandamaya Kosha, which is Jada, is thought about as Atma. Anandamaya Kosha is Ajnana. So they have landed on Ajnana. Karana Sharira, not Atma really. Because Atma is Chetana, Anandamaya Kosha is Jada. They have landed on the Sushupta Anandamaya Kosha as Atma. They have missed the Chetanatvam there in the Sushupti, which is Anandamaya Kosha Vilakshana. Tasmad Guda Chaitanya Anandamaya Koshe Eva Tayoho. That Chaitanya which is hidden in the Anandamaya Kosha is Pratyagatma. They have missed the Pratyagatma, which is Chaitanya Surupa, and concluded that Anandamaya Kosha, in Anandamaya Kosha, that Guda Chaitanya is lost. And then they think that Atmatva is there in Anandamaya Kosha. They may not know that they have landed on Anandamaya Kosha, but Jadatvat, because their conclusion is in Jada, it has to be Anandamaya Kosha, and it is Buddhi Vyatirikta, and their assertion is analysis through Sushupti analysis. Their assertion is through Sushupti analysis. Therefore, the Sushupta Atma being Jada is not Atma being Jada. Sushupta Anandamaya Kosha is Jada, so their conclusion has to be due to Anandamaya Kosha misunderstood as Atma. Thereby, they have not landed on Atma at all. Atmatva Bhranti Rasti. There is a Bhranti of Atma, but it is really Kosha. Apicha, Tanmate Atma Surupam Nitya Jnanam Na Jive Abhimatam. Kintu Anitya Jnanam Eva Jive Abhimatam. Since this Jnana comes and goes, Chaitanya comes and goes, that Jnana which comes and goes with Manas Sanyoga has to be Anitya Jnana. So in Jiva, what kind of Jnana is there? Anitya Jnana is there, not Nitya Jnana. The way Siddhanta says, Atma Swarupa is Nitya Jnana Rupa. Satyam Jnanam Anantam is Lakshana Vakya. The mantra is Lakshana Vakya of Atma, Brahma. That Brahmatma cannot have Jnanam, which is Anitya. So it is Shruti Virodha also. Shruti Viruddha, this Anitya Jnana in Jiva is Shruti Viruddha. तच्च अनित्यं ज्ञानं सिद्धान्ते अंतःकरण वृत्त्यात्मक बुद्धि रूपं भवति. Whereas we say ज्ञाना दैट इज अनित्य इज वृत्ति रूप. सेम थिंग दैट द क्षणिक विज्ञानवादी सेज विज्ञान ही क्षणिक अनित्य. नैयायिका इज डूइंग नो डिफरेंट एनालिसिस. देर आर डिफरेंसेस इन डिटेल्स बट इफ यू लुक एट द कंक्लूजन Jnana being anitya, one aspect of the Nayayika is also Jnana is anitya. Atma is there. So there is a difference between Kshanika Vijnana Vadi and Nayayikas in that substratum being Atma. But what kind of Atma for Nayayikas as opposed to Siddhanti? That Atma where Jnana, Buddhi is a guna and it's Agantuka. Being Agantuka, Jnana is Anitya in Atma. Sometimes there, sometimes not there. That is Vritti. It is not Jnana, Chidrupa Jnana. It is Vrittyatmaka Jnana, not Chidatmaka Jnana. They have missed out the final kosha refutation. So there is a difference between, there is some commonality in one aspect of Nayayikas and Bauddhas, because Bauddhas have borrowed from Nayayikas. They are also Tarka Pradhana. In fact, everyone other than the Advaita Vedantin, everyone is Tarka Pradhana. All are Dvaitins, all are Tarka Pradhana. Because Shruti is taken selectively, not wholesale. Some do not take the Shruti at all. Itham Prabhakara Nayayikayor Mate Anandame Koshe Atma Buddhis. Buddhi tasya atmana gunaha. So what is the mata final conclusion when you analyze what they are talking about? They have landed on anandamaya kosha as atma and atma guna is buddhi. We'll come back to this. There is a tippana there. So tippana refutation of Prabhakara Nayayika mata is Prabhakara Nayayikayo mata khandanam shushuptau jnana bhavad atma jadaha. In Shushupti, Jnana not being there, Atma being there, Atma has to be Jada. This is their conclusion. Chaitanya is not there in Shushupti Avastha. This is their conclusion and we know the refutation. Sukham aham asvapsam na kinchid avedisham iti paramarsha balat Shushuptau sukha jnana yoho anubhavasya upapaditattva tesham vachanam baditam bhavati. Anubhava virodha is there. Everyone knows that when I slept happily, blissfully I slept and I did not know anything. Not knowing anything shows that you were witness. So you must have seen something. If you ask anyone who has woken up, have you slept well? Yes. How do you know? Because I saw nothing. So you saw nothing. You are witness to nothing. You are witness to that shunya. That Sakshi Rupa Atma is Chetana. I slept happily. How? I cognized bliss. I had Sukha Anubhava. So Jada cannot have Anubhava. Anubhava Sukha is for the Chetana Vastu, which is Atma. So that Atma is there and it is Chetana in Shushupti Avastha also. Therefore, Paramarsha Balat. Shushuptau Sukha Jnana Yoho Anubhavasya Upapadituttvat. Since you describe your Shushupti Avastha on waking up, you have to be Chetana during Shushupti also. Tesham Vachanam Baditam Bhavati. By Anubhava it is refuted. Atma Yadi and anybody's Anubhava. Atma Yadi Swarupataha Jadasyat Tada Shushuptau Anubhutasya Anandasya Smaranam Nasyat. Had the Atma been really Jada in Shushupti Avastha, you wouldn't have Anubhava. Anubhava lacking, there won't be smarana of that Anubhava. You don't recall somebody else's Anubhava. You recall your own Anubhava. You don't look up something, read something and collecting data, you call it as Anubhava. You don't look at something like a memory card, you know. When there are arguments, you know, the moderners argue that why can't Atma be like a program, you know. Like a program which isn't there. When it boots up, it looks up the memory and then it recalls that there is a, you know, that's why it is called a memory card or RAM. So it's a memory. The memory is registered and the program reads the memory on waking up, like the program reads the memory on waking up and knows what to do next. Similarly, Atma wakes up to this Smriti. If you say it wakes up to the memory, whose memory? There is somebody who is written, somebody in the case of program. Also, what is it that knows that it has to read this part of the memory and continue from there? There is Pratyabhijna in the case of Chetana Vastu. In the case of programming also, there is a Chetana who wrote the program there. The program is not dead. It is not completely gone. The program is running. It is taking to know at what time to wake up. So you cannot say that it is not there. The program running program is similar to Chaitanya being there. It is running. Running is it is kept alive. It is Chetana. It is a witness to time ticking. In the programmatic world, what I call as a watchdog. So a watchdog would be there which will wake the program. So something is there which triggers the program to manifest and get to the memory and continue. So if you draw that kind of simile, so moderners draw the simile, that can also be explained. The watchdog which is ticking, that is Chetana. So comparable, Chetana is there. Something will be there which will get you through to the memory. So that Chetanatvam is there in Sushupti Avastha also. Tasmad Atma na Jadaha. Going back to the Mula, Sadhu says, Idam api matam na samichinam. This mata is also invalid, this Prabhakaranayayaka mata, which is Anandamaya Kosha really. And Atma being Jada is not acceptable. Jnana bhinnam yadyat jadavastu ghatadikam tatsarvam anityam asti. If you say Jnana is anitya, Jnana is a guna of Atma, anitya Jnana is guna of Atma, Atma is Jada, then Jadatvat, Anityatvat, what is it? Jadatvat and Anitya Jnana. Because of that, what will happen? Sarvam Anityam. Ghatadikam Sarvam Anityam Yatha Tatha Atma Api Anitya. Atma will become Anitya. Because Jnana Bhinnam Yadya Jadavastu Ghatadikam Tat Sarvam Anityam. Whatever is other than the subject, the object, it is all anitya. So without knowing that jnana is anitya and atma is nitya, without knowing that, you will land on anityatvam for atma also. They have analyzed. They call themselves as tarkikas, but they have failed tarka also. Why so? Because jnana bhinna yadyat jada vastu. There is a vyapti. Yatra yatra jadatvam, jnana bhinna jadatvam. Because jnana is there, then it cannot be called as jada. Yatra yatra jnana bhinna jadatvam, tatra tatra anityatvam. There is a vyapti. So we explain this vyapti, his own vyapti system. Tarka has two parts, Nyaya Shastra has two parts. One is there, darshana, which is based on tarka. That tarka which is there, the analysis, whereby they, you know, make conditional steps that talk about five steps or three steps. Those are all valid. Good for analysis. So you use their tools and explain it. Through their own tools, we refute their own system. Ushtar lagodal nyaya. So you beat him, you beat the logician with logic itself. Jnana bhinnam yadyat jadavastu ghatadikam. Example for that. Udharana tat sarvam anityam. Yadi atma jnana swarupa na bhavet. If there is no swarupata jnanam in atma, if it is agantuka jnana, anitya jnana, then what will happen? Tada ghatadivat jadaha anityascha bhavet atma. Atma will become anitya like jadavastu, any ghatadi vastu, prapancha. Atmana anityatve mokshanvayinaha abhavat moksha sadhananam nishprayojanata syat. Then atma itself is anitya. If you still argue as to, oh, okay, Atma is anitya, so what? So then who will get moksha? Same problem that we have refuted in earlier cases also. We have seen that if Atma is anitya, like in Kshanika Vijnanavada, Atma comes and goes, then who gets moksha? You talk about nitya moksha. Moksha avastha is nitya, has to be nitya. Even if you say moksha is something which is anitya also, somebody has to get it. Who will get it? If there is no one continuing between the two kshanas, who gets moksha? Forget pratyabhijna. Who has pratyabhijna? That is a refutation. But we ask him, okay, moksha is the goal, right? Nirvana, you say. Who gets nirvana? Somebody who gets nirvana should be existent continuously. In fact, continuous existence itself is moksha. Similarly, Tarkika also has concluded that Atma is Jada. Therefore, because Jnana is Agantuka. When you say Jnana is Agantuka, Chetana becomes a manifested part of Atma, something manifests in Atma, then whether or not an Ayayaka agrees, he has ended up with an erroneous conclusion that Atma is Jada, even if it is not in so many words. And Jadatvat Anityaha Atma, Anityatvat Nishprayojanata, Moksha Sadhanana. Moksha is not possible, sadhana is useless, therefore the entire Shruti has been set aside by this so-called Vaidika Astika Tarkika. Itham Vedanta Vakyeshu Ashraddhanaha Bahirmukaha Purusha Guru Sampradaya Shunyaha Panchakosheshu Anyatamam Meva Swasva Buddhyanusarena Atmatvena Manvanaha Mukhyatmanam Sakshinam Na Jananti. Put together, all the darshanas have one common factor. Not one common factor, what is common among them? So many commonalities are there. Darshanas may vary. Philosophical conclusions may vary. Buddhis are different, therefore, Buddhi Kalpita, Swakapola Kalpita, units are varying among these. But what is common? Vedanta Vakyeshu Ashraddha Dhana. Ashraddha Dhanattam is common. They don't have complete Shraddha, if at all there is any Shraddha, because Nastikas do not have it. But Astikas have Shraddha. That Shraddha is not complete in Vedanta Vakya. Otherwise, they wouldn't base their conclusions on logic alone. Shushka Tarka wouldn't be the basis. Bahirmukaha, towards Tarka, they are focused, which is outside the Shruti. It is not Shruti-based Tarka. Such philosophy Purushaha, Guru Sampradaya Shunyaha. So, Guru Sampradaya Shunyattam is common. Vedanta Vakyeshu Ashraddha Dhanattam is common, Bahirmukhattam is common, Guru Sampradaya Shunyattam is common, because Guru Sampradaya has been left by them, Tarka is Pradhana. They keep on making various conclusions based on their own Tarka. They add on to Tarka and then they differ from their own Guru, there is no Sampradaya. Because it is, although you claim, you know, began from Narayana Shiva, so Nayayikas consider Shiva as their Guru. Adi Guru, but still they fall apart from the Shruti. Panchakosheshu Anyatamam Meva Swasva Buddhyanusarena Atmatvena Manvanaha. So one of the Panchakoshas they have concluded as Atma, which is the refrain. In refutation, there is a Koshatvam is a refrain there. In Shruti, the refutation at each level of these, Annamaya, Pranamaya, Manomaya, Vijnanamaya and Anandamaya, Koshatvam is a refrain. It's a refutation by Koshatvam. Natu Atma, Kosha Eva. So one of these they have landed on and considered as Atma. They have not gone further at all. They got stuck at the Adhyaropa level. They have not gone to the Apavada complete. वाई बिकॉज स्वस्वबुद्धि अनुसारेण तस्माद् अन्नमयादयः आत्मनः आच्छादकत्वात् कोशा इति वर्णयन्ति. सो दे कंक्लूड दैट सम ऑफ दीज आर कोशास बट देन दे लैंड ऑन वन ऑफ दीज कोशास एज आत्मा. ईश्वरीय पंचकोशैः तत्स्वरूपाच्छादनम्. नाउ दीज पंचकोशास हैव आल्सो यू नो दे आर बोर्न आउट ऑफ ईश्वर. एवरीथिंग हैज कम फ्रॉम ईश्वर एंड दीज पंचकोशास हाइड दी स्वरूप ऑफ आत्मा. देयर इज अ आवरण ड्यू टू अज्ञान दैट इज आच्छादनम. यथा जीवस्य पंचकोशा जीवस्य यथार्थ स्वरूपं साक्षिणम् आवृण्वन्ति तथा ईश्वरस्य समष्टि पंचकोशा ईश्वरस्य यथार्थ स्वरूपं आवृण्वन्ति. जस्ट लाइक देयर इज अ व्यष्टि आवरण देयर इज समष्टि आवरण आल्सो. देयर इज पंचकोश विच इज बोर्न आउट ऑफ ईश्वर फॉर जीवा एंड द पंचकोशास विच आर बोर्न दे आल्सो वेल द ईश्वर आल्सो. Now there is a difference here. What is the difference? Difference is that Ishvara. So Ishvarasya Yatharta Swarupam Avrunvanti. When Jeevasya Yatharta Swarupam Sakshinam Avrunvanti Yatha. Just like Jeevas Panchakoshas veil the Jeevas Yatharta Swarupa. Similarly, the Samashti Panchakoshas of Ishvara, they veil the Ishvara Swarupa. But for whom? There is a difference. The जीवाज यथार्थ स्वरूप इज वेल्ड फॉर जीवा. ईश्वराज यथार्थ स्वरूप इज ऑल्सो वेल्ड फॉर जीवा अलोन नॉट फॉर ईश्वर. ईश्वर नोज हिज ओन स्वरूप. ही वेल्स माया एज शक्ति वेर एज दैट माया मैनिफेस्ट कॉल्ड एज अविद्या इज नॉट अ शक्ति फॉर द जीवा. इट इज अ शक्ति फॉर ईश्वर टू वेल द स्वरूप ऑफ जीवा फॉर जीवा. And also veil the swarupa of Ishvara for Jiva, not for Ishvara. Ishvara knows Jiva swarupa also, knows Ishvara his own swarupa also. Tatha hi Ishvarasya yatharthaṁ swarupaṁ. We'll just look at Tippana and come back. So there is Ishvarasya, what I explained, it is from Tippana as well. So yatha Jivasya panchakosha Jivasya nijas swarupaṁ pratyagātmanam Jiva drishtim pratyachhyādayanti. न तथा ईश्वरस्य पंचकोशा ईश्वरस्य निजम स्वरूपम ईश्वर दृष्टिम प्रत्याच्छादयन्ति. जस्ट लाइक द पंचकोशास वेल द जीवास ओन स्वरूप टू जीवा. सिमिलरली ईश्वरास पंचकोशास डोंट वेल द ईश्वरास स्वरूप टू ईश्वर. निज स्वरूप एंड ईश्वर दृष्टि दे आर नॉट वेल्ड. ईश्वरस्य आवरण रहितत्वेन नित्य मुक्तत्वात् न तस्य किञ्चिदपि कर्तव्यमस्ति. ईश्वर डज नॉट हैव टू डू एनीथिंग बिकॉज ही इज नित्य मुक्त. ईश्वर इज नित्य मुक्त बिकॉज आवरण इज नॉट देयर. विक्षेप इज मिथ्या मायाकृत ही इज नित्य मुक्त. किञ्चिदपि कर्तव्यं नास्ति ईश्वरस्य तस्मात् यथा व्यष्टि पंचकोशेभ्यः प्रत्यगात्मनो विवेचनं जीवेन कर्तव्यम् तथा समष्टि पंचकोशेभ्य ब्रह्मण विवेचनम अपि जीवेन एव कर्तव्यम्. सो हू हैज टू डू दिस पंचकोश विवेक. जीवा हू नीड्स मुक्ति हैज टू डू दि पंचकोश विवेक. आउट ऑफ द ट्रायड ऑफ जगत जीवा एंड ईश्वर हू हैज टू डू दि विवेक. जगत इज जड़ा डज नॉट नीड मुक्ति इवन. ईश्वर इज नित्य मुक्त चेतना बट नित्य मुक्त. सो हू नीड्स मोक्ष जीवा नीड्स मोक्ष. सो पंचकोश विवेक हैज टू बी डन बाय जीवा. हूज पंचकोश विवेक ही इज ओन. एंड इफ ही डज हिज ओन पंचकोश विवेक द जगत विल रिमेन आउटसाइड. दिस जगत इज वन ऑफ द कोशास ऑफ ईश्वर. सो ईश्वर हू हैज जगत हैज कोश विल बी सेट असाइड. जीवाज in the jagat with individual parts of the jagat as their own koshas, they'll also be set aside. So you'll have many jivas with many koshas outside of you. You will have one Ishvara with the samashti koshas outside of you, you will still remain a jiva. Even if you do panchakosha viveka, you will land on the sankhya atma. Sankhyas and yogis consider this atma as individual atma, different from the koshas, all right, but still separate chetana, separate from Ishvara, separate from other chetana jivas, jivatmas. That is not the conclusion. That will not lead to moksha at all. Aikya will lead to moksha. So panchakosha viveka is not only at the jiva's level to be done by the jiva, but he has to do panchakosha viveka at the samashti level also, which includes other jivas, not only other jivas, his own jiva sharira also. Other jiva shariras, including his own jiva sharira, is a part of the Ishwariya panchakoshas. So that is the meaning of Ishwariya. Ishwariya can be seen as related to Ishvara, as in being born out of Ishvara also Ishwariya panchakosha. But what is the meaning here? It is Ishvara's panchakoshas, which veil the Ishvara's swarupa. Veil the Ishvara's swarupa for the jiva. So he also has to understand the Ishvara tattva. This is tat padartha. Tvam padartha has to be understood. So not only tvam padartha, but tat padartha also has to be understood. Therefore, panchakosha viveka has to be at vyashti as well as samashti level. That is being said here. Tasmad yatha vyashti panchakoshebhya pratyagatmano vivechanam jivena kartavyam tatha samashti panchakoshebhya brahmana vivechanam api jivena eva kartavyam. So tatpada panchakosha viveka also has to be done by jiva, just like he does the panchakosha viveka at the tvampada level. Sadrupa, chidrupa, anandarupa, advayaha iti atmanah chatvari visheshanani. So you can look at the lakshana, atma lakshana visheshana. So visheshanas are of two types. One is lakshana visheshana and the other is which will separate out. So what we generally know as visheshana, that is the first type of visheshana. But lakshana is not to differentiate from another of the same type, of the same species, because there is no other atma, no other brahma. So brahma atma visheshanas are not to separate from another atma, another brahma, but it is to differentiate from everything. That is the lakshana. So lakshana visheshana sadrupa, atma is sat, atma is chit, atma is ananda, ananda swarupa, and atma is advaya. Now if you look at these four, how these work, a very interesting and very nice explanation there. Deha dehetu anrutaha jadaha dukkha rupa sadvaya iti chatvari visheshanani. Whereas anatma deha visheshanas are what? Anrutaha, mithya, jada, achetana, dukkha rupa, not ananda rupa. So you look at sat, but here you have anruta. Chidrupa, here jada, meaning achit. Ananda rupa, dukkha rupa. Ananda is sukha, manifests as sukha. Dukkha rupa we know. Advaya, whereas it is sadvaya. So here there is advitiyatvam in the atma. In anatma you have dvitiyatvam, sadvitiyatvam. So deha dehe anatmanah tu anruta jadaha dukkha rupa sadvaya iti chatvari visheshanani. Now what does what is very nicely explained. Tatra atmanah sadrupa chidrupabhyam deha dehe anruta jada rupayoho tirodhanam bhavati. This tadatmya sambandha, when it takes place, what exactly happens? He says that sadrupa and chidrupa of atma, due to this sadrupa and chidrupa of atma, what happens here is deha dehe anruta jada rupayoho tirodhanam bhavati. This sadrupa is lent to the deha, anatma, deha ityadi, dehadi. Every all anatma, their sadrupa is lent. Therefore, you say asti, there is something there. So you don't see that it isn't there. Meaning mithyatvam is lost on us because we see the anatma also as existing. Deha asti, shariram asti, buddhi asti. All this astitvam, prapancha, and then deha, they extend into prapancha, asti, asti, asti. There is an anuvritti of sat. Therefore, sadrupa of atma masks the anruta rupa of prapancha. Similarly, chidrupa masks the jada rupa of anatma. Chidrupa of atma veils the jada rupa of anatma by extending bhana. Therefore, we say bhati, asti, bhati. So, astitvam and bhana is there because sadrupa and chidrupa respectively veil the, they mask the anruta and jada rupa of anatma. Then the other way round, dukkha rupa and sadvaya mask the of the anatma, mask the ananda rupa of atma and advaya rupa of atma. So this is how the mishrikarana is explained very nicely, you know, that mishrikarana, which Bhagavan Bhashyakara says mithunikaranam, sarasad, yushmadasmat pratyaya. There is a mishrikarana, there is a mithunikarana that is explained here as dukkha rupa and sadvaya mask the ananda rupa and advaya of atma. That is said here, tasma dehadihi satvena chetanatvena cha bhati, dehadehe dukkha rupena sadvayatvena cha atmana ananda rupatva, ananda rupatva advayatvayoho abhibhavaha bhavati. And we saw the other way masking is dukkha rupa and sadvaya mask the ananda rupa and advaya of atma, sadrupa and chidrupa of atma mask the anruta and jada rupa of dehadi anatma. Atascha atma dukkhitvena sadvitiyatvena cha bhati. This is the reason, one thing that atma, there is a lot of dukkha in me, there is another and yet another. Ittham atmana panchakoshanam cha anyonya adhyasa asti. This is anyonya adhyasa mithunikaranam yushmad and asmad pratyaya gochara vichar. So what is this yushmat pratyaya? Yushmat pratyaya is used for idam or dehadi anatma, and asmat pratyaya in adhyasa bhashya, you see Bhagavan Bhashyakara has written that asmat pratyaya is the atma. Tasmat mukshur avashyam panchakosha vivechanam kuryat. So panchakosha viveka should be done by the mumukshu. Moksha should do it. Moksha ichchu, and not only at the vyashti level, also at the samashti level. We'll continue in the next part with the Moola 282nd, which we started off and we took a detour after the first sentence on the Tippana Ishwarasya. Sukhan Nityam Swaprakasham Vyapakan Namurve Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Drukyat Nirvana Param Sarvedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadevahannamattonyat Iti Menishchitamatihi. Namaste. Any questions?